Welcome back to my playthrough at the LDC number 29 contest loss. And today we're going to be going over my contest loss. Yeah, the time has finally come for that. And the reason why it took much longer than expected is because I was still waiting for intended slash acceptable solutions to all of my levels first. Yeah, before I recorded the video. And sadly, there was one level that I was not able to get completely patched up before the deadline for the update phase. But well, you know, sometimes that's the way it goes. And there was bound to be like the level I had was just pretty much bound to be like unpatchable. And because there was plenty of things where I was just playing with the low in my head, and I was like, oh wow, yeah, I haven't realized like the many ways in which players could just like do things differently, yeah, than what I had in mind, yeah, for my low. But oh well, yeah, that's the way it goes, you know. What can you do about it? But in any case, yeah, I did the best I could. Yeah, I really went down fighting, yeah, and to eliminate as much glaring backroutes as I could, yeah, before the end of the update phase. And so that's that. But anyway, yeah, now this video was just go through the intended solutions for my levels. So we're gonna go ahead and start with my Route 1 here. Alrighty, first up we have Route 14. Amazing brick house evacuation. So yes, there are some neutrals here, and yeah, you need to say 32 of them. And yeah, pretty much for this LDC, I pretty much forced myself to use neutrals and zombies. Yeah, especially since I haven't used them since the very first LDC that I participated in as a low designer, which was LDC number 22. So that was from like 3 years ago. So yeah, I'm actually amazed it's already been that long since the very first LDC I participated in as a level designer. And the level title here, it's pretty much a reference to one of Leviathan's custom levels. It was called How to Evacuate a Gold Mine. Yeah, and I was very, very amazed by that trick that I saw there. And so I just wanted to like make a level, yeah, based on that. So, and this was the result I came up with. Now, interestingly enough, I had another level in progress that I was working on, but I haven't gotten back to it for almost a year now. Yeah, I should really, really get back into the levels that I wanted to make, but haven't really gotten around to doing so. It really just requires me to, like, just open up the editor and start fiddling around and stuff. But, well, yeah, like I said, this was the result, yeah, as an inspiration from Leviathan's custom level here. So, really, I just wanted to make a level around this trick where a basher keeps on going because of the terrain. Yeah, the way the terrain is set up. So, the first thing I do is I bash with the very first lemming here. And, yeah, with one of the last few lemmings here, I go ahead and platform up the gap here. Okay, and then I go ahead and place a blocker here so that it turns the basher and he keeps going the other way. Yeah, so really in Leviathan's custom though, it's nothing but keeping this basher going with blockers. But in my low, of course, yeah, I decided to do more than just that. Oh yes, and I forgot, yeah. There's three hatches here, yeah. Two of them are neutral hatches, this one and this one. This one is a pre-assigned climber hatch, while this one is a pre-assigned swimmer hatch. Yeah, and then at this time, I go ahead and build here so that the others can, like, get back up. Yeah, while this lemming keeps going over the top here. Who will... Oh, yes, and I released the blocker with a walker here. Yeah, basically for some timing here. And then for here, I go ahead and build and clone. Alrighty, so by this point, yeah, everyone has turned around except for this lemming that's coming, who I released from his blocking duties up here. Alrighty, so now with the builders done, yeah, everyone else who comes here will be contained, safely contained. Alrighty, and then the walker that just overtook the basher, he blocks here. So again, we're going to keep the basher going so that he can release the pre-assigned neutral swimmers here. Alrighty, and then another trick that I want to enforce here is there's no way to access this exit other than to shoot a laser from below. And here I just wanted to show off the power of the laser, where, yeah, it is the ability to go through water. Yeah, and continue on its merry way until it reaches its maximum range, or hits steel slash one-way arrows, etc. So this really goes to show you the power of the laser here. Yeah, for Neo Lemmix. And yeah. Now at this point, when enough of the climbers have started climbing to the top exit, I go ahead and fence and clone. Yeah, and you do this at the base of the bridges here. Yeah, this is the only way where you can reach both the button and the middle exit. Alrighty, and then once all the swimmers are turned around and the normal lemming is coming up, I go ahead and release the blocker with a walker here. Alrighty, these guys will just exit in the meantime here. Alrighty, so this exit can take two more lemmings slash neutrals, but you also have a limited exit down here of 10. Yeah, and there happens to be 10 of each here. So 10 normal lemmings, 10 neutrals who are climbers, and 10 neutrals who are swimmers. So as you can probably guess, all these 10 swimmers will be using the bottom right exit. Or rather, the bottom exit. And so, how do you do that? Well, with the remaining two lemmings, yeah, it should be clear that these two normal lemmings are the remaining ones for this exit here. And so, what you do here is, you mine through the staircase, and then quickly reassign him a jumper, so that he does not fall through and drown. Yeah, that's how you get your requirement here. So these two normal lemmings, as I said, will use the middle exit, while their neutrals will just simply use the bottom exit. Yeah, so again, it's like I said, I really forced myself to use neutrals here because I was like, I think I can see great potential with the neutrals with the load that I had in mind. But in any case, yeah, this seems to be pretty well liked. Yeah, at least by Amani, and maybe Icho too, but yeah, I'll wait until I watch his video and stuff. Yeah, or if I prompt him to, but well, yeah, again, I think I'll just wait for the video. And also for the music track, yeah, that is a track that you can hear from the PSP port of the game. It's titled Old Tune because, you know, you can hear she'll be coming around the mountain in pretty much all the ports, different ports of the game. And on the PSP version, yeah, there are three tracks that you can hear for each tile set. This particular tune that plays on this lower here, this old tune, it is pretty random when they play. Yeah, so in other words, yeah, for any given level in the PSP port, yeah, it will either play one of the three tracks for that tile set or one of the random three old tunes. Yeah, one of them being she'll be coming around the mountain. Yeah, the other two are the Can-Can and Pachelbel's Cannon. Yeah, and those three old tunes are not tied to any tile set. Yeah, in the PSP port. So really, for any given level, you will either hear the three tracks associated with that tile set or one of the three old tunes. And because there aren't that many crystal levels, yeah, in Lemmings 1. Yeah, you can expect to not hear the tunes in the crystal tile sets that much. And it's skewed even more, yeah, if the game decides to choose one of the old tunes instead. So yes, there you have it. I pretty much got the game when it first came out. Back when I was in high school, yeah, in my junior year. So that was back in 2006, I believe. Yeah, when the game came out. And I was a junior, 2005, 2006. So anyway, yeah, that's my rule one here. So let's go ahead and move on to my rule two now. Which is, rule 2-4, Lemmings versus the Jolly Roger Pirates. And here, like I said, yeah, this is the law with zombies. Yeah, because again, I kind of forced myself to use zombies. And I, was thinking of some kind of level where you are pretty much fighting the enemy. And so basically the zombies are your enemies on this level. And in case you can't tell, yeah, that's supposed to be a pirate ship. Yeah, if it's not already obvious from the lower title or from the Jolly Roger flag that you see up here. Yeah, the reason why it's very comical and goofy looking is because, you know, I don't really have any artistic abilities whatsoever. Yeah, I never was and still am not an artist. So, there you have it. That's my really, really not very good looking pirate ship whatsoever. But yeah, now that we're in though, yeah, here's a better look at it. And oh my goodness, this went through so many changes. So all these one-way arrows and then these spike traps. Ugh, it was really, really hard to enforce what I had in mind, yeah, for my solution. And yeah, this even went through a reworking and slash overhaul. So originally, yeah, I ran into some skill set problems because I was at my max of 10 skill types. And so in earlier drafts, yeah, the hatch was a swimmer hatch, even though I did not want it to be. And yeah, later on, yeah, Icho kind of opened my eyes here because I was like, oh, wait, yeah, he does have a point. Yeah, I couldn't make this low without it being a swimmer hatch after all, because I was successful in getting rid of two skill types. Because in earlier drafts, you originally had blockers and walkers. But yeah, it seems that the walkers were a major source of backroutes. Yeah. And so as a result, yeah, I got rid of that and also the blockers. And in turn, they got replaced by the swimmer and a stacker. And yeah, also some lower reworkings as well. Yeah, so in particular, there used to be another gap here that you need to like platform and then build up to get up this wooden staircase. But then I was like, yeah, I'll get rid of it because... yeah, it seems that the even though there were three builders, it still seems that it would still be very, very backroutable and everything. And so, yeah, I decided to like not take chances there. And for the final update, yeah, I just resorted to pickups just because I was like, yeah, I'm not taking any chances here because this level has already gone through a lot of backroute hell. And even now, yeah, it's still like pretty much unpatchable. And, you know, I'm not very happy about that, but well. There are some levels that are bound to be like that. Yeah, where a solution you had in mind is so complicated that, yeah, it's like pretty much backroutable no matter what. And, but anyway, yeah, just a more overview at the low. Yeah, there's a lone zombie up here who is a pre-assigned climber, swimmer, and floater. While there's a zombie hatch, there are pre-assigned swimmers. And pretty much I think of this as pretty much like, you know, the normal lemmings are like the... or like Peter Pan and the Lost Boys here. I guess you can consider the pre-placed lemming here as Peter Pan. Yeah, just without the climber ability since... I don't know. Flying, in a way, is kind of like climbing, I guess, but... you know. Yeah, I just pretend that, yeah, that it's Peter Pan and the Lost Boys, yeah, who will be coming out of hatch versus the pirates here. Yeah, which are double the number. And up here, the lone zombie is kind of like... Captain Hook. And pretty much your goal here is to, like, infiltrate the pirate ship and, like, get rid of these zombies, including Captain Hook himself. So, yeah, you can pretty much imagine this as, like, being in Neverland, and then this is, like, Hangman's Tree, yeah, their hideout slash, home. Yeah, Peter Pan and the Lost Boys, that is. And, yeah, I even added a rope and, anchoring down the ship here, yeah, in the water. So, yes, I did do some tiles and mixing here. Yeah, pretty much the very first time I ever done so for a level, I think. Yeah, other than that one rule in a previous LDC where you mixed two tile sets. Yeah, and on top of that, yeah, just a treasure chest here. And then the Jolly Roger flag, as I mentioned. And then some hanging swords here. Yeah. But anyway, for this level, yeah, I think I'm just going to go ahead and show off what I had in mind. And then I'll just show off Icho's solution as you see here. Yeah, and for this, I thank Icho for all those resolves and everything. But anyway, yeah, this pre-placed numbing will go ahead and platform, while the last numbing for the entrance will stack. Yeah, once he turns around, he goes ahead and builds so that he gets up here. And then both of these become swimmers. When the platform is done, he collects the jumper pickups for them. Oh, and the track that you're listening to here, yeah, it's called Sudden Death, and it comes from an online game called Gunbound, which was a game done by Sister Show and me a really long time ago, back when I was in, I might have been in middle school that time. Middle school? No. I think I might have been in high school that time. Either middle school or high school, yeah. But it was definitely a long time ago, though. But yeah, it comes from a game called Gunbound. And basically the goal is that you play as one of these characters called Mobius. And the goal is to eliminate all players from the opposing team first, before they can eliminate all players from your team, including yourself. And yeah, there's a mode, I think it's called Versus mode. Yeah, I don't remember the modes now, but yeah, there's one mode called like Versus or something like that, where if the game goes on long enough, if no one has eliminated every player from the other team first, yeah, before a preset determined amount of moves or something like that, yeah, then the game switches to a mode called Sudden Death. And when it does, it starts playing this track here. And I was like, ooh, I love this track. It really gives that epic feel to the battle and stuff. Yeah, like you're fighting to the death. Yeah, hence why it's called Sudden Death. And it pretty much continues until, yeah, the game finally ends when you eliminate all players from the other team, or they eliminate all of your team and yourself, yeah, first. But yeah, it was a very fun, addictive game back then. And and this was definitely one of my favorite tracks from that game. And yeah, because you are fighting against the enemy here, I thought it quite fitting to use this track here. So yeah. But anyway, yeah. Then I shoot a laser here to open the path for the lone zombie here. And then I just continue assign jumpers here. Yeah, force on timing here. Yeah, so that he can escape the zombie before he gets infected. In the meantime, the other swimmer will shoot a laser here, and then once he's through, once it breaks through, yeah, I go ahead and make him shimmy. Yeah, one more jumper, and then just bash. Yeah, pretty precise here, but yeah, at this instant, yeah, I go ahead and make him shimmy. Yeah, this is how you make him escape the zombie here. Yeah, at least in my solution. And then he'll stop because of the rope. Yeah, which I added. Yeah, in a more recent version. Yeah, and then this other swimmer will platform up the gap here. Yeah, who shall not turn around. Alrighty, and then these two workers will go on. Yeah, this one needs a shimmy, of course. Yeah, others will just walk into the crocodile trap. And yeah, you can think of the crocodile as like TikTok. Yeah, which is pretty much the name given to the crocodile. Yeah, who goes for Captain Hook because he loved the taste of his hand so much that he decided to come for the rest of him. Come to eat the rest of them. Okay, and then when you get up here, collect 2 digger pickups and then 3 more jumper pickups. Okay, and then you platform up the gap here. Okay, bash on through. And this is where some timing is needed here. Yeah, that's the reason why I stacked with the last lemon for the entrance. Yeah, so the other one can turn around at some point and then dig down this wooden pillar. Okay, and then the basher, once he reaches here, will dig down the other wooden pillar. Okay, and then once we're low enough, yeah, but just before you can break the zombies through, yeah, I'll go ahead and make this one jump. Okay, and then at the pretty much the first instant that the zombies are able to step up and everything, yeah, I'll go ahead and make him jump so that he avoids infection from the zombies. Okay, and then of course jump over the fascia tunnel here. Okay, and that's how he escapes the zombies. Yeah, the other lemming in the meantime will go on back up here. Okay, so all these pirates, yeah, will get eaten by the crocodile now. Yeah, even though in the movie and the, maybe even the novel itself, but I have not read it, so I don't know. Even though only Captain Hook gets chased by the crocodile. Okay, and then I go ahead and build up here. And then because this wooden pillar is too high, yeah, I go ahead and make him platform. Okay, and then when the gap is closed, I go ahead and make him bash. And yes, and the remaining zombies get eaten by the crocodile here. And yeah, there's supposed to be only one, but yeah, I decided, hey, why not? Let's add 2 of them. I pretty much went for like symmetry here. Yeah, for the most part. At least with respect to the pirate ship. Okay, and then of course, platform over the rope trap here. Okay, and then once you're far enough inward, yeah, then you go ahead and laser through the rope net here so that you can like get up here. Where you're calling a miner pickup. Yeah, and then at this time I go ahead and release the crowd with the platformer. You have to get over the stack. And then of course platform up this gap. And then of course the miners used to reduce the fall so that no one splats. Yeah, so that they can reach the exit safely. And that's it. So yeah, this is what I had in mind. And now, as I mentioned, yeah, I'm going to go ahead and show off Icho's solution, which he just sent me this morning, yeah, several hours ago. So, it's not exactly the intended, but it's quite close that I actually consider this acceptable, and not like a very glaring background like in all the other versions of this level. So yes, he is correct. He is correct in that this is pretty close. But anyway, what he does is he stacks at a spot so that the last two lemmings from the entrance will turn around. Yeah, while everyone else is contained. And then, yeah, the start is the same here. Platformer then build. Okay, platformer becomes a swimmer. Collects the jumper pickups. Okay, and then one difference here is that at the spot where he lasers, where, yeah, right here, that the lone zombie can still break through and fall down here. And so because of the spot where he lasers, yeah, he does not need to use all those jumpers like I did in order to avoid the zombie. So instead, he bashes through, and then, yeah, of course, this is still the same, laser and then shimmy. Another difference here is jumping and then shimmy to avoid the zombie here. Yeah, and now he gives him a swimmer here. Okay, and then poor Captain Hook gets eaten by the crocodile, or TikTok. Yeah, and then platform, of course. Okay, shimmy. So, of course, to avoid death, yeah, to the crocodile owner. Okay, collect the pickups here. Platform. Okay, another crucial difference here. Yeah, let the platformer turn around, while the other one that's coming up bash on through instead. Okay, and then he shoots a laser to get on through later. Okay, so he goes on to dig down this wooden pillar. Okay, and then also dig it down this wooden pillar with the other one, with the other worker. Okay, and then this part is the same as mine, of course. Yep, so I think it was pretty much the exact same situation with the zombie, spacing and everything. Yeah, where, it was pretty close, but luckily the spacing was just right to avoid infection here. So then you jump, and then jump again, of course. Yeah, otherwise he'll just swim straight into the crocodile. Okay, and now the rest of the zombies, as before, will just get eaten by the crocodile. Well, except for the survivors, who will get eaten over here, I think. Yeah, so it seems like two of them, just like in mine. Okay, and then he makes the digger jump. Okay, and then jump again, of course. Yeah, because you don't have any other skills to avoid death to the crocodile here. Okay, and then platform over the rope drop here. Okay, and then at this time he goes ahead and releases the crowd by bashing through the stack. Okay, and another part that's more effective than mine, which is popping up the gap, and then once he's far enough, then go ahead and build. Yeah, which interestingly enough, he does not hit his head. Yeah, so the result is the same here, yeah, as before now. Yeah, they can, like, get over the top here to collect the miner pickup. Okay, platform up the gap. And they finally use the miner to reach the exit safely. So, yeah, I think in a way, if I wanted to, I could, like, pretty much put some more stuff in the way so that... actually, no, it wouldn't work. Yeah, pretty much you can change this by just releasing the crowd later, so that you don't have lemmings turning around and finish a little quicker that way. But, yeah, in any case, yeah, what you have in the end, or in Itchel's solution, yeah, two jumpers and a platformer left. Yeah, basically, I intended the platformer, yeah, to to be the way to release the crowd, yeah, as you saw in my solution. But instead, he uses the basher, yeah, where I intended the basher to be up here. Yeah, so then you laser through after, later on. So pretty much, yeah, I think for the most part, I would pretty much make Icho's solution the new intended solution to this level. Yeah, because it's definitely more effective than mine, yeah, in this area, for example. I think really the only part left that I would enforce is, basically the timing that I did here with the digging down the wooden pillars. And I think pretty much the way I could do that is maybe just like redesigning this area here so that, like, in case you do turn back, yeah, they'll just walk into like a trap or something. But then I realized you can pretty much still do something different in that, like, if you get low enough with this pillar, yeah, then you can just simply jump, yeah, to avoid the zombies after. Yeah, because you can just release the zombies. Oh, actually, excuse me. Oh no, actually no, it won't work because then the zombies would just chase the others around. So you can consider that like a pirate attack. Yeah, the pirates attacking the lemmings and stuff. No, never mind, it won't work. Yeah, so I think if I wanted to force that, yeah, I would just like redesign this area so that in case lemmings do turn back, yeah, there's a trap right behind them waiting for them. Yeah, waiting to kill them if that happens. But other than that, yeah, other than enforcing the timing that I had here, yeah, in my solution, yeah, I would pretty much make the rest of it, adopt Icho's solution as the new intended one. So yeah, I gotta say, yeah, great job to Icho here. And thank you so much for the results, yeah. Yeah, even if I thought it was like annoying, yeah, that I kept releasing updates because of how the solutions I kept getting were like backroutes and everything. So I do apologize if it was, but well, it's like I said though, yeah, even now, yeah, even if I do enforce that timing, yeah, that I did with workers, yeah, it's pretty much like unpatchable for the most part. And so, yeah, other than that part that I would probably enforce, yeah, in like a future update or something, yeah, I would probably just, make Icho's solution the new intended one. Yeah, because it's definitely more effective, yeah, right up where the sails are at the very top, yeah, than my solution. So, yes, there you go. There's the very, like, backroutable, unpatchable route to, for me. And now we go ahead to my route 3, which is route 3-4. Fun teleportation race in space. So pretty much the only level of mine, yeah, in this contest where you are allowed to lose a lemming here. And yeah, I have three solutions here, but they were pretty much all just variations of how you can do the start. Yeah, and it would still, and the intended solution would still work. By the way, yeah, I'll just show up the first one here. And the track you are listening to here, yeah, it's the Blue Danube Waltz. Yeah, as you might know. Yeah, a pretty common piece. Common classical piece here. And this comes from a game called The Incredible Tomb Machine, which was a game that my dad got both my brother and me, yeah, back when we were little. And yeah, if you're familiar with the Incredible Puzzle, The Incredible Machine series, then yeah, that game is probably unknown to you, but yeah, I have gotten some responses from some members, yeah, on Discord where they told me, oh yeah, I remember this game. Yeah, I'm just like, oh yeah, that's great to know that there are some who are familiar with this one then. Yeah, and I'm not the only one. It is a bit more obscure compared to the other Incredible Machine games, but yeah, it is one of the more fun ones in my opinion, yeah, because of the cartoon physics and everything that the game employs. But anyway, yeah, for my solution, yeah, after one lemming gets released, I go ahead and max the release rate, yeah, for two lemmings, I think. Yes, no, three lemmings, sorry. So the first one will build over the water gap to reach the structure up here, or this platform, I should say. Yeah, the first lemming in this train will block to turn the other two around. Yeah, the other one's hidden behind this one. So, one of them would use the teleporter, and the other one will, slip by. So, yeah, in the previous video, it's like I said, yeah, this is another space level, but this time for me. Yeah, very similar to Icho, but the big difference here is that in my solution, or in my level, yeah, you do have to touch the release rate. So while it is just one more than the starting release rate in Icho's level, yeah, in my solution, or rather my level, yeah, you will have to touch the release rate here. But yeah. So anyway, yeah, with the two last lemmings in for the entrance, I go ahead and max out the release rate again. Yeah, again, to have one lemming get past the teleporter, the second one, yeah, who becomes a slider. Yeah, who go back to out to the left, and then platform up this gap. Yeah, in the meantime, this builder used the teleporter, and pops out up here. And yeah, the first lemming to come out from here will block before the teleporter. And then, yeah, of course, the lemming that reaches here will build to get over the gap here. Okay, and then this builder will build to get to finish the next gap here. Yeah, this platformer turns around. So yeah, the builder finishes in time, but now you have a problem. Yeah, the slider is now too close to the lead lemming. So it seems that he will just slip through the teleporter and then just fall to his death here. And indeed, that will be the case. So, what do you do here? Well, there's a trick here that I want to put in this level where you just simply block with the slider right in front of the teleporter. Because once the teleporter is finished, yeah, then the blocker that's right on top of the trigger area will get a transporter up here, or rather teleporter. And then, what else did I do here? Okay, looks like I made him a climber. Yeah, and then it released this blocker with a walker here. Yeah, everyone else will now be able to use the teleporter here. Yeah, because the spacing is still fine here. Yeah, so that no one slips by the teleporter. And then I released this blocker with a walker. So now he goes into the teleporter and pops out here. And yes, this teleporter here leads to over here. Okay, and then when you're high enough with the climber, you go ahead and bomb to make a hole here for the other climber. Yeah, who's coming now? Yeah, so give him a climber. Okay, so now everyone else is safely contained here. Yeah, thanks to the blocker that's in front of the receiver. So go ahead and bash here. Yeah, dig down the one-way wall here. Okay, and now everyone can reach the exit. And then finally, once everyone has turned around, yeah, then you go ahead and release the blocker with a walker. And that's it. So there you have it. That's the solution to my R3. And this level came about because I was inspired by two of Icho's levels from Lemmings United. Yeah, one from the Tension rank, and then the other one from the War rank. Both in the space levels, interestingly enough. Yeah, in particular, this part was inspired by the Tension level, while this part here, with the transporting or teleporting a blocker, was inspired by the War level, by the level in the War rank. So yeah. And then it's like I said, yeah, the other solutions, the other replays I have are just simply variations of how you do the start. You could, for example, release four lemmings at the very start, at a 99 release rate. Yeah, where same thing, first one goes on ahead and does the building, and then the second one blocks. Yeah, and then, what was the other one? Oh yes, the other one is just, yeah, you don't max out the release rate until two lemmings are dropped out instead of one. So, yeah. So everything else is just the same now here. Yeah, and then maxing out the release rate with the final two lemmings here. Yeah, and then everything else is just the same. And then, again, like I said, with the second replay, yeah, here, just max out the release rate for four lemmings, yeah, to start. Yeah, build with the first one, and then block with the second. And then everything else is the same. So, there you have it. So I'm just gonna go ahead and load the first replay, and then just skip straight to the end here. Hopefully my lows were fine this time. I'm pretty sure I got some positive feedback by pretty much everyone who has played my lows here. So, yeah, and I'm pretty sure it'll be the same with Icho once he records his videos and stuff on his solutions. It seems that these lows were pretty well liked. Yeah. And I've got to say that I was really touched with hearing the positive comments and everything on my lows. So, it's kind of like gotten me to keep my head up and everything. Yeah, and be hopeful and optimistic. So, thank you to everyone who has played my lows and sent me solutions and showed me whether there were backroutes or not. So, yeah. Okay, so those were the solutions to my lows. And so that pretty much completes the playthrough of the LDC number 29 contest lows. So, if you've been watching since the beginning, and thank you for doing so, and I hope you enjoy seeing the what I had in mind for my lows, and I'll see you all for future projects that I do, whether it be more contest lows or future LPs of lower packs, Lemmings lower packs, or whatnot. So, with this, have a great day, everyone, and see you guys all around.